Greetings, NTCA members. Can you believe that the year is almost over? It has certainly been one for the ages, and one where NTCA members and your commitment to the communities you serve has really been a silver lining for all of us. As you know, NTCA recently announced that our time is going to be held virtually in 2021 to keep our members and our staff safe and to provide the best possible experience under the circumstances. We're going to be providing compelling, timely, relevant content, effective networking opportunities, and connections to solutions from associate members and other vendors. I really encourage you to take advantage of the money that you'll save on your flights and your hotels and dining with Mickey Mouse, and invite more employees to tune in. This is going to help foster a diverse set of skills among your team and expose them to some national activity, which can only help your company and our industry. The dates have not changed, so mark your calendars for the week of February 22nd. Registration is going to be open soon, so keep an eye on your inbox. The election was certainly a nail-biter, with record turnout and many races too close to call on election night. Now that Joe Biden has been declared the president-elect, NTCA is committed to working with his administration to promote sustainable networks for years to come, ensuring that every American can access robust, reliable broadband. While the initial results were unclear, what is clear is that access to broadband will be top of mind in the next Congress, and we need your help to keep it there. Our advocacy and communication teams want to hear your stories about how broadband is impacting your communities, as well as what challenges you face in deploying your networks. Please share your stories at communications@ntca.org. The USDA Reconnect program is a great example of NTCA members working with the federal government. NTCA members have secured hundreds of millions of dollars in funding to connect families, businesses, farms, schools, and first responders to high-speed access. We're so grateful to the working relationship we have with USDA, and we've really appreciated working with Chad Roop, the administrator. He and I are going to have a chat on our critical connections on December 2nd, so please join us. Speaking of supporting rural communities, and given that we're in November, remembering Veterans Day, FRS recently opened another virtual living room at the VFW in Tennessee so that deserving veterans can get access to telemedicine care regardless of where they live. Ben Lohman Connect, CoBank, all were terrific partners on this venture. Our virtual cybersecurity summit is coming up December 8th. We're going to be hearing from industry professionals and managing your cyber risks. We've got a great array of speakers, and I'm marking my calendar as well. Cybersecurity continues to be so important to all of us in this industry, particularly with the pandemic and the vulnerabilities it has exposed. I really do hope you make attending this summit a priority for your technical team. Members of our CyberShare program are going to get 50% off their admission to the summit. So if you're not already a member, it's a great time to join and a great tool for you. For those of you who knew Jim Bass, he had a great impact on our association and our industry, and we were so sad to learn of his passing this year. However, we're really looking forward to funding the legal education for future legal eagles from rural America, and the NTCA board has raised almost $30,000 to date. We will be matching that up to about $62,000 before the end of the year, so go check it out and make a contribution to the Jim Bass Legal Foundation FRS Scholarship Fund. In closing, I would be really remiss if I didn't thank you for everything that you're doing for your communities and your active participation in NTCA. I know this year has thrown us a lot of curveballs, but I think there's ways that we're going to find lots of opportunities in the year ahead. We are going to make the most of your story. We're going to continue telling the Smart Rural Community story. And with that, I wish you a happy and healthy Thanksgiving. Thanks for all you do.
Hello, NTCA members. This is Laura Withers, Vice President of Strategic Communications for NTCA. I miss seeing all of your faces in person, but videos like this will have to do for now. The staff at NTCA have been so impressed and amazed by your efforts this year to keep your communities connected, to connect more communities and families, and to do it all in a very safe and healthy way, which we know has not been easy. Some of the most heartwarming stories we've heard this year are about your companies and your employees helping school children who have been forced to quickly adapt to distance learning. Earlier this fall, NTCA partnered with Digital Bridge K-12, an initiative of Education Superhighway, to join its K-12 Bridge to Broadband program. This program helps rural broadband providers and school districts across the country work together to make sure that every student who has internet connection at home can make good use of it this year. By joining this program and giving us some contact information about your company, we will list you on the NTCA website and also share that information with Digital Bridge for an online lookup tool to help school systems connect with ISPs to discuss working together to connect students. You can find more about this on our homepage at ntca.org by clicking on the link for Digital Bridge K-12 program. One of my favorite stories of helping students this year came from Polar Communications in Park River, North Dakota. Polar jumped into action earlier this spring to help their school districts in their area make sure that kids could get access to schoolwork online. Polar CEO Carl Blake recognized that these students were thrown into a situation they were not prepared for, but Polar was there to help and connected over 120 students who did not have internet hooked up at home. I want to say thank you again for everything you are doing and to share Polar's exceptional story with you.
Hi, my name is Shane Azier. I'm the superintendent of Northwood Public School. We realized that education the last 45 days of school was going to look a little bit differently. We had high hopes that we would maybe be back in the last week or two of school. That didn't happen.
The superintendents in our service area started calling and saying, okay, we're going to an online-based learning system and we have students that don't have internet access. What can we do to connect them?
Knowing that there's not fiber at some of these locations, knowing that we don't know if the fiber is good at some of the locations, how do we do a professional installation without going into the house? That was our biggest challenge. So we would pre-mount everything on a whiteboard, the ONT, the router, all the power cables.
We would work with the customer, maybe putting it through a window or something temporary, call the customer and try to talk them through the setting up, the hooking up of the equipment.
It was important for all of our 316 students to have the technology as their peers had. They were here within a day or two to make sure that our parents and our students were connected.
There was a lot of calling people, calling the customers, and getting things scheduled and working with them, trying to make sure that every kid was able to get their education.
They were thrown into a world that they're not familiar with, and going home, they didn't have that structure anymore, and their world was kind of turned upside down, and this was just a small piece that we could do to try and bring some structure back to not only their teachers and schools, but some of their classmates as well.